Senator Rick Scott has a plan. It's an 11-point plan to rescue America.
Is he leaving? Is he taking 11 trips out of America?
It's causing a bit of a stir among Republicans because you're not supposed to say these things out loud.
Leader McConnell, can I ask you about Senator Rick Scott? He's introduced an agenda that Democrats have seized on, includes tax increases. It's been very controversial. I wonder what your thoughts on this are.
Well, Senator Scott is behind me, and he can address the issue of his particular measure. If we're fortunate enough to have the majority next year, I'll be the majority leader. I'll decide in consultation with my members what to put on the floor.
But what this does, among the things that it would do, is to impose income taxes on more than half of Americans who pay none currently.
And let me tell you what would not be a part of our agenda. We will not have as part of our agenda a bill that raises taxes on half of the American people.
And to sunset all legislation, all federal legislation, after 5 years. And apparently that includes Social Security and Medicare.
And sunsets Social Security and Medicare within 5 years. That will not be part of a Republican Senate majority agenda.
So let me read you points 5 and 6 of Rick Scott's 11-point plan to rescue America. Quote, "We will grow America's economy, starve Washington's economy, and stop socialism. Socialism is un-American and always leads to poverty and oppression. We will stop it. We will shrink the federal government, reduce the government workforce by 25% in 5 years, sell government buildings and assets, and rid the old, slow, closed, top-down government-run everything system we have today.
So I can commit more fraud and not get caught."
Right. Then nobody will be looking. And so people like him can, you know, rip us off all the more. Although maybe not, because there won't be any federal programs to rip off. They'll just be doing it at the state level.
Right.
Apparently he just wants to move everything to the state level where there's, you know, less oversight. And wealthy people and corporations can get away with almost anything. Okay, so that was point five. Point six, quote, "We will eliminate all federal programs that can be done locally and enact term limits for federal bureaucrats and Congress. Many government agencies should either be moved out of Washington or shuttered entirely. Yesterday's old government is fundamentally incompatible with the digital era. The permanent ruling class in Washington is bankrupting us with inflation and debt, so they must be removed. For you to have more, Washington must have less."
Amazing.
And this flies in the face of reality, which is that the federal government, when it is operating correctly, and when the agencies are not staffed with saboteurs, which is what the Republicans do when they get power, they actually try to limit the abuses of corporations, at least some of the time. He wants to make sure that, there's no limitation whatsoever. He also said, quote, "All Americans should pay some income tax to have skin in the game. Even a small amount. Currently, over half of Americans pay no income tax. Last year, 57% of U.S. households pay no income tax, but that was by design. If you remember, all the tax cuts passed by Republicans, you know, the George Bush tax cuts, two of them, of course, going back to Reagan and Trump, was the latest one that really reduced the number of Americans paying taxes because he doubled the standard deduction. So, you know, whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, those, you know, fewer people are paying income taxes because of these tax reductions. And it's also important to remember that all those tax cuts overwhelmingly benefited the wealthy, because people, you know, making $50,000 or less weren't paying that much in taxes anyway, and or at least income taxes. So, yeah, and you have to remember that all workers, virtually all of them, pay Social Security, Medicare, and sales taxes, as well as other fines and fees that are imposed on them by government. So it's not like they're not paying taxes. It just rubs this, you know, multimillionaire the wrong way that some people aren't paying an income tax because they make so you know, such a low income.
A week ago, he was on Fox News, and I have to say, you know, I'm no big fan of Fox. What little I see of Fox is disgraceful, but sometimes you see this.
America, two of the big points of which are, quote, all Americans should pay some income tax to have skin in the game, even if a small amount. Currently, over half of Americans pay no income tax. It also says all federal legislation sunsets in 5 years. If a law is worth keeping, Congress can pass it again. So that would raise taxes on half of Americans and potentially sunset programs like Medicare, Medicaid, and Social Security. Why would you propose something like that in an election year?
Sure. Well, John, that's, of course, the Democrat talking point. It's a
No, it's in the plan.
Here's the thing about reality for a second. Let's talk about Medicare.
But Senator, hang on.
John.
So it's not a Democratic talking point. It's in the plan.
And also in the plan, it says we ought to every year talk about exactly how we're going to fix Medicare and Social Security.
That's why, well, yeah. Is that satisfying? I mean, does it pay to have a liar like that on your show and scream at him for like 10 seconds and then have him move on shamelessly? What's the value to those interviews?
Hey, the more press that this gets, David, the better.
Right.
You know, because it shows who the Republicans are. He just happens to be pretty stupid to be saying this before an election. But this has always been the Republican program. They have rhetoric that may say, oh, no, you know, we wouldn't do that. But whenever they get a chance, that's what they try to do, is to reduce programs that help the majority of Americans and institute programs that help a tiny sliver of Americans.
Right.
The wealthiest, the people who don't need any help. That's who they want to serve. The Nonpartisan Tax Policy Center estimated that ensuring all households pay at least $100 in income taxes would leave families making about $54,000 or less with more than 80% of the tax increase. Those making less than about $100,000 would shoulder 97% of the cost. So 97% of the tax increase would be paid by people making under $100,000. That's who he wants to target with the tax increases.
Is any of this stuff ever going to see the light of day? I think, as you said, McConnell, they're pissed off at him. So for saying what they're thinking, but none of this is actually going to make it into the halls of Congress, correct?
Oh, I don't know about that. If the Republicans get the Senate and they get the House and they get the presidency in 2024, it very, very well could. I mean, you know, the moderate Republican Mitt Romney, who voted for the Supreme Court nominee, Judge Jackson, when his vote would make no difference, right? He's great at being moderate when his actions have no real impact on what the result is. But he wants to increase the age at which you qualify for Medicare from 65 to 67, and increase the age when you qualify for Social Security from 67 to 69. That's how he wants to address the so-called shortfall in the Social Security Trust Fund. Now, there's another proposal that is in the House that is called the Social Security 2100 Act, which would, it's currently in the House Ways and Means Committee. This is a bill that's proposed by Representative John Larson of Connecticut, and it has 208 co-sponsors. All of them are Democrats. The Social Security 2100 Act calls for increasing benefits, including a broad boost equal to 2% of the average benefit and a new minimum benefit that would be 25% above the poverty line. So this would ensure that no one over the age of 67 is living in poverty, at least the official poverty level.
So it's bad for the country, but it's going to be great for us